This is the first of a series of three videos on derivative skills. We will first just go through some basic skills, the constant rule, the power rule, and simple rewriting. This is part one. Part two will involve product rule, quotient rule, and chain rule. And then the third thing that we'll do is write the equation of a tangent line. Before we start working on derivatives, it's always a good idea to look at some basic review types of problems. And I've just spelled out here some very easy basic examples. We're going to want to work with exponents and not with radicals. So in these first two examples, the square root of x means the same thing as x to the 1/2 power. That is because the basic rule is the nth root of x to the p power is always going to be x to the p over n power. Same thing with number two. The fourth root of x cubed is simply x to the 3/4 power. The other thing that we want to make sure we understand is negative exponents. 1 over x means exactly the same thing as x to the negative 1 power. 3 over x to the 5th means the same thing as 3x to the negative 5th power. The last piece that I want to talk about is what happens, let's do an example 5. If I have something like negative 3 minus 1, working with integers, remember that would be negative 4. In number 6, if I have something like negative 1/2 minus 1, think about that as negative 1/2 minus 2 over 2, right? Because 1, in terms of the fraction with denominator 2, which would give us negative 3/2. So these are kind of those basic skills that you're going to need to be successful as we go through these derivatives. Hopefully you've taken the opportunity to look at the PowerPoint that actually has all of the rules spelled out. But in this video, we're going to talk about the three kind of very basic rules. The derivative of a constant is zero. And think about what I'm talking about there. If the derivative of the constant is zero, that's a function like f of x is equal to 7. 7 is a constant, the derivative of that is zero, but think about it more geometrically even. Wouldn't that be the line y is equal to 7? And if it's the line y is equal to 7, isn't that just a horizontal line? And remember, the slope, right, of a tangent to a curve is the first derivative. So the slope of every horizontal line is zero. When we look at our next basic function, we're basically just saying, okay, so suppose we've got f of x is equal to something, just a coefficient times x raised to a power. The basic rule is you take the power on x, you multiply it down by the coefficient, and then you drop the exponent by 1. So if I had something very simple like f of x is equal to 3x squared. I take the 2, I multiply it by the 3, I get 6, drop 2 by 1, and I end up with 6x is the derivative there. We'll get more practice with this, but this is just the whole basic idea. And then what we could also have is we could have a bunch of terms added together. Perhaps we have things that we can use the power function for, constant rule. We're just going to move through and take the derivative of each piece. Okay, so the first one, f of x is equal to 3, that is a constant, and we're going to use our constant rule. The derivative of a constant is 0, so the way that we would write that is that f prime of x is equal to 0, and we're done. In the second one, we are looking at using our power rule and the whole idea of really a polynomial rule where we're going to move through each piece. Well, the first thing that we have to do in many of our examples, especially when we start, we will rewrite the original function. The reason that we rewrite it is so that we can get our expressions in terms of exponents and powers. So 4x to the 1/3 power plus 2 is the rewrite of g of x. 4x to the 1/3 was the place that, or the piece that we really needed to work with. Now, from here, we can simply find our derivative. So g prime of x, using the power rule, we're going to take 1/3, multiply it by 4, that gives us 4/3. X, we're going to drop 1/3 by 1, meaning we're going to say 1/3 minus 1, which is 1/3 minus 3/3, which is negative 2/3. And if it helps you, you might want to go off to the side and do that arithmetic, or at least think through it that way. And then the last piece, the derivative of that plus 2 is 0. So when you get here, you're done. Number 3 is a simple polynomial, and we just move through it piece by piece. So we're going to start off h prime of x. Our derivative notation is simply going to be 2 times 4 is 8, x, let's drop the power of 2 by 1, and it leaves us with 1. We can write it or not. Plus, this one's always fun to look at because the power of x is 1, 1 times 3 is 3, but when we subtract 1 from 1, we get x to the 0, and I'm going to write it for the first time through. But remember, any number raised to the 0 power is 1. And then the constant of 8, the derivative of that is 0. So I kind of write out this funky derivative because we will not leave it like that, but I want you to see how it follows the rule. What we will write as our answer is very simply 8x plus 3. In number 4, we don't have to do any rewriting in number 4 because we can see we have coefficients and powers. I want to show you a good way to write this. So we're going to say the derivative, using our shortcut rule, 3 times 2/3. For some of you, you might need to write it like this to begin. 3 times 2/3, x is going to be to the 2nd power. Remember, we're going to take our original power and subtract 1. Plus 2 times 4/5, x to the 2 minus 1 power is going to be x to the 1st power. And the derivative of 9 is 0. We would want to simplify here. So let's say f prime of x is equal to, here some of you might recognize that we can reduce those 3's and we have 2x squared plus 8/5 x. In number 5, we are going to do a rewrite. And the rewrite for g of x is 4x to the negative 3rd power. It's important to do that because now we can use our power rule, and very simply, g prime of x then would be negative 3 times 4, negative 12, x to the negative 3 minus 1 power. And I write this out because I want to make sure that you're not going to make a careless mistake here. That would give us negative 12x to the negative 4th power. Remember, you're decreasing your power by 1. In number 6, we also want to do a rewrite. Once we learn a little bit more of our advanced skills, we might do one like number 6 differently. But for right now, what we want to say is 3 times, I'm going to square out 5 minus x, that would be 25, minus 10x, plus x squared, and I could simplify it one more time, and say 75 minus 30x plus 3x squared. And once I do that, then what happens is it's easy to move through that. Remember, this step, or two steps here, that's the rewrite. The derivative is when I start using my rule. So when I go through this, the derivative of 75 is 0. The derivative of negative 30x is simply negative 30. And the derivative of 3x squared would be plus 6x. Number 7 is also a basic one, and you could approach it just by looking at this as three different fractions. And as you start with the rewrite, 2x cubed over 2x squared is simply 2x. When you move to the second part, minus 4x squared over x squared, well, that's just 4. Minus 4. And then when you move to the third part, you've got plus 3 over x squared, which in turn we could rewrite as 3x to the negative 2. Now it's ready for the derivative. The derivative of 2x is 2. The derivative of negative 4 is 0, so we're just going to skip over that. We move to the last piece. Negative 2 times positive 3 is negative 6. Notice I put that joining symbol there, x. So what looked complicated really was something quite simple when we got down to looking at the derivative. In number 8, we're continuing with our basic functions here. And because this is basic, the first thing that I would do is I would rewrite it. And so the rewrite of this is simply just x to the third power plus 2x squared plus x squared plus 2x. Notice all I did was FOIL that out. X squared times x, x cubed, 2x times x, 2x squared, 2x times 1, 2x, and then this little piece in here where I got the x squared from is just x squared times 1. And then I could rewrite that to say x cubed plus 3x squared plus 2x. And now, when I go to take the derivative, g prime of x is equal to 3x squared plus 6x plus 2. In number 9, when you look through h of x, there's really only one piece that needs to be rewritten. So let's take that piece off to the side and think about it as negative 4x to the negative 4th. Now, let's take the derivative. Using our basic rules, the derivative of 7x squared is 14x. The derivative of negative 3x is negative 3. When I now think of this negative 4x to the negative 4 to take the derivative, negative 4 times negative 4, again my joining symbol is important, positive 16, x to the negative 5th, remember negative 4 minus 1, and then the derivative of 5, that constant, is 0. So I'm finished. When I look at number 10, I really don't need to rewrite anything. There's just some basic things that I need to consider when I'm thinking about 10. So let's go ahead and start finding the derivative. The derivative, f prime of x, is going to be 2/3 times 1 is 2/3. The first pass, it might look just like this so that I know that I'm not finished with it. I want to come back and work on it a little bit more. Minus 3x squared, and then pi is a constant, so the derivative of pi is simply going to be 0. Now let's look at this piece and think about how we might want to rewrite this. 2/3 x. Remember again, it's 2/3 minus 1 or 2/3 minus 3/3, right? Which is negative 1/3. So this video really just took into account our basic situations.